Hi. Tech Rabbit here again with a head cough. Need to get another lens.
Hi.
Anyway, sorry for the background noise, but it's plus 30 Celsius where I am, and with the air conditioning running for a while. I think I'll turn it off maybe a little bit later. Anyway, here's my old workstation, and I thought I would actually just make a video, because I'm going to disassemble this. I'm not going to keep it, and I'm just going to salvage some parts out. It's been a very good case, but it's, you know, it hasn't got any front panel USB-C, the usual. And the insides are a little bit sort of old-fashioned there for big hard drives, large physical hard drives. So it's, and then the fans are, the case fans are pretty old, so I think we're just going to trash it for now. Anyway, this is a nice case because it has screws on the back, but I've taken them out. But basically, just need to open up this to get access to the front panel. Cabling's not that incredible. Throw away this fan, it's too old. Start with that. Little helper appeared. I wonder if you'd like to join me. It's a bit cooler here in the garage. But anyway, so now we got this cover off, so this can basically be trashed. Come on, Chaz. He's just standing there looking at what am I doing. This will go into the electronic scrap. So let's see, what else do we find? Screws here. Screw box. Oh, Maybe we should try and disconnect some of the internal cable first. Had these kind of like slot in fans. See, the idea was tallest installation fans. Oh, this might even be an original. Sorry, I need to get some pliers. Old-fashioned speed control. Just does it potential. Goes in the garbage, definitely. I was ever going to reuse this case, which I'm not, because I'm going to throw it away. Because you can position it up here, you can put it in the middle. But you can actually screw the fans on, so you actually don't need those tabs. Runtime is quite high, but oh, that's quite useful. Optical drive. CD-ROM drive. Actually amazing that most, quite a lot of new computers you can buy still have an optical drive. Usually when you build one yourself, the case you buy doesn't, all the good cases, they don't even have a place for an optical drive. The thing is, this power supply is a very good power supply. It's a Corsair 750, but I've been running it non-stop for so many years that I think I'm going to commit it to the garbage. Used a bit too much. Typical with these really old case. You even have an adapter plate for the power supply. This case I've used for years. Oh, keep on dropping screws. Pulled all the cables. Maybe we should just take this out. Not modular. This one. Wait. Control Y. Just for runtime reasons, I think I want to get rid of that power supply. Cables going to the front panel. Oh, this is my adapter. Oh, wow. Now, this is a cool adapter that ASUS used to include with its motherboards. It's like a header where you can put all the front panel controls onto this one and then just plug this one, and this is really nice. I'm keeping this. Take it to another pile and throw it away. That was so useful. They stopped including it. Something in my memory says that I have to take the front panel off to get something off. What would that be? Really need to take the front panel off. So anyway, then we can take the drives out. Ah, there's one more fan. Yeah, I think we're gonna throw that one away. It's got a, not the best, it's got a ETX 1050 4 gig. So I upgraded the graphics card, the motherboard is also upgraded. But then I ran into this issue with the ATX command being missing. So the motherboard processor combination, which is the last in its lineage, you can't upgrade the processor to have ABA. Have a processor with AVX. So I'm going to, I have to trash the motherboard processor. I'm going to keep the memory. That's pretty new. But it's DDR3 memory. I have 16 gigs. But actually works for most workloads, even gaming quite well. But I haven't got the space to keep multiple machines. And as I said, that it has its legacy limitations. Oh, Oh, look at this. This was also modular. You can actually just take it out. Yeah, had an accident with coffee and children. The actual whole computer, all the grid and everything got covered in coffee. Now, tried to clean it up. Wasn't that easy. And then this thing, with, you know, with these custom rail adapters, like this has it, it gets to be a bit of a problem. Oh, no. No, I think I've lost the package that the thing was. And this is just the, this is the DVD burner. Blu-ray, this player, and DVD burner. I mean, the thing is, it's not cost efficient to use optical discs for anything, not if you want to think of storage. I have, actually do have a DVD burner, but the media is so expensive and unpractical. It makes it basically a useless function. So actually the question is, why do they make Blu-ray writing drives? I mean, what's the point? I don't know of any. And they sell the media also, but what's the use case? Let's see. Anyway, maybe somebody can... Key, I think I lost that years ago. You have to be careful to take this out. This might actually have a lock. Let's see. Yeah, that's the lock. You have to remember to... lock for the video card. You need to make sure you take it up. This one moves. You have to remember to take that off if you don't want to end up busting the cord or force it, putting extra force on this connector and ruining it. Now I think we can get the drive. Here I actually have an SSD. So that's been upgraded with a very odd, like, media adapter to our bay adapter. So that was the most. Take off the adapter away. As I said, no native SSD locations in this. In this case, we didn't have SSDs. In those days, for desktops. And then, another X years from now, people not going to understand what the SSD places are for, because all drives are going to be installed on that motherboard. So that's that. No tools installation for the stuff in this case, except for the actual bay. turbine drives. That awful. Use that. So now the only thing remaining is the motherboard. Which is sadly obsolete. So we'll have to take all the motherboard screws out. Actually easier to do. Let's wind down. I wonder if I should reposition the camera. Okay, alright, let's go with a bit of a better view angle, even though it's not that important to see. So there are, how many screws? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 9 screw, standard screw configuration. I think I'll just make a quick job of this. It won't have to be so careful. I'm not going to keep this motherboard. For dropping screws. Most screws dropped. Oh, there's one more. Another one. Oh. Anything else? Just a bunch of dust. Oh, this fucking scrap. Continue with the same angle because now I'm going to so as sad as things are, the only thing I can really salvage is memory. Those are completely valid. Quite good memory actually, but as I said, DDR3. Actually, upgrade a server. That would be another idea, is to build a server, because this box is too big, so I'm gonna make like a U1 configuration or something. Cheap server motherboard. Now, I don't know if I want to keep this. Or it's actually a cheapo I bought from China. It has LEDs in it. But I don't know. it's the probability that I'm going to buy the same processor or even mess with this kind of stuff. As I said, I have limited space and money, so I think having one computer to look after is pretty much enough. Yeah, anyway, that's how you take a computer apart. I hope you enjoyed that. It's some useful in the future. Anyway, if you like this video, then consider subscribing. Click the bell icon to get notifications. We'll continue with the projects. Yeah, actually the PC build project is, which this is a part of, nearly complete. I might make a few more follow-up videos after this one for certain details, but we'll see. See if there's any comments that people are interested. But I think I basically can say that this is PC build series is come to an end. Anyway, it was fun to do, and a bit sad I had to take this whole one apart, but as I said, I don't have the space and it doesn't support the AVX instruction set, so that screws it with me. Yeah. Anyway, see you in the next one.